Good morning, MHS. This is your student bulletin for Friday, November 19th, 2004. I'm Alex Miranda.
And I'm Adam Clapper, and today is Army Day, and we show our support for our troops in the United States Army. And following our program today, we'll be showing a list of things you can donate to our troops overseas. And if you'd like to donate these, you can drop them off at the hub or the other house offices. Attention all students parking in the MHS lots. Every student must have a parking pass. Starting today, your car will be ticketed if you do not have a pass. We will also start towing cars that are in violation. Towed cars would have to be recovered at your own expense. If you do not have a pass, please see the hub to purchase one immediately. And attention all, the Encore Entertainment Company, Madonna High School Show Choir, will be the host of the Southwest Show Choir Festival this coming Monday, November 22nd. If you enjoy pop and Broadway music, fancy costumes, singing and dancing, then come see the show choirs from Solon, Brecksville, Strongsville, North Royalton, Westlake, and ETC of Akron, as well as our own Encore Entertainment Company. The show will be held on the main stage in the Performing Arts area. Tickets are now available at the ticket office during lunch periods at a cost of $5.
Sub pickup. The subs are done just in time for the Ohio State Michigan game. Orders can be picked up at the hub at 3 o'clock today. Also, there are extra subs available at the hub, available for $4. Thank you for supporting the troops. Emerging Leaders Club. The next meeting is on Monday, November 22nd at 6:50 in the Denson's Learning Room. Please do not forget over the weekend. We will have a follow-up meeting on Tuesday at 7 a.m., also in the Denson's Learning Room. Our speaker is Mr. Michael Kovach, Medina County Auditor. Please be as prompt as possible.
And for West Side Story, there will be an informational meeting and sign-ups for auditions for West Side Story on Tuesday, November 23rd, right after school in the Middle Auditorium. We will be discussing the audition format, rehearsal schedule, and passing out audition monologues. If you cannot attend, please see Mrs. Steffen or Mr. Bianchi before Thanksgiving break. And also, from the Drama Club, all students interested in attending area conference at Sandusky High School on Saturday, January 22nd, must have their complete registration forms and $10 fee turned in to Mrs. Steffen in room 1206, no later than Tuesday, November 23rd. If you need a registration form, please see Mrs. Steffen before Tuesday.
And today, we are supporting the troops, but we can't forget about the big game tomorrow. Glenn Quick and I have the opportunity to go down to Columbus and investigate the Ohio State Buckeyes.
Ohio State versus Michigan, one of college football's greatest rivalries. This Gridiron Classic takes place right here at the Horseshoe. And tomorrow, the battle begins.
105,000 screaming Scarlet and Grays will be packed in Ohio Stadium tomorrow to help create Michigan's worst nightmare. Although the Buckeyes come into the game 4-point underdogs to the Michigan Wolverines, all records are thrown out in these types of games, which means anything can happen. Head coach Jim Tressel comments about how to get ready for the Michigan Wolverines.
If and when opportunities, and usually when you prepare and prepare and prepare, good things happen, typically.
I also had the chance to talk to two senior captains and how they feel about their last home game against Michigan.
When I came in as a freshman, that was probably one of the first things I looked at was, what was my last game in the shoe going to be? And it turns out it was going to be against Michigan. So ever since freshman year, you've been pumped that you get to go against those guys from up north, in your final game in the shoe.
It's a good feeling because you know you can be like, you've done something for the team and everything and for the university, but you always think, I'm almost done. Like, it's almost over.
This game between Ohio State and Michigan will be the 101st meeting of these two teams. And as any Buckeye fan can tell you, a win against Michigan will make the next 12 months ahead that much better. Reporting for NBC, I'm Alex Miranda.
Mike Nugent, I'm place kicker number 85 for Ohio State, and make it a good one, Medina.
Thanks, Mike. And Adam, did you know that the Maurice Corrett story came out when I was down there?
Really?
Yeah, it was a great experience. And now the moment you've all been waiting for. The bookstore is now open. Stop by the Beehive in the middle cafeteria for all your school needs. We're open every day during the lunch periods. Seniors, if you're interested in talking to the rep from John Carroll, fourth period, on Monday, please sign up at the hub. And now we have a special guest today, Cece Hall and her sister, who is going to Iraq.
Thank you, Alex. Good morning. How are you?
I'm a little tired. I just flew in from Amsterdam, but it's good to be here.
Wow. Do you want to tell us your name and a little something about you?
My name's Melissa McElhannon from Medina. Graduated in 1998, and then I went to Ohio State. I'm currently a communications officer in Bamberg, Germany, for the military police.
And I heard you were going to Iraq soon?
Yes. December 5th, we're deploying to Iraq, a little town called Ashraf.
Mm-hmm. That's wonderful. Is there anything you'd like to say to everyone watching today?
I'd like to thank everybody, especially my sister, the homecoming queen, and my mother, Norma Hall, for all your support, all the faculty and staff and students here at Medina High School. We really appreciate everything you've done.
And you're going to be here for a while?
Yes, I'll be in and out of the school talking to some of the students about the Army and the job that we're going to be doing over in Iraq. So feel free to come talk to me anytime. Lots of knowledge.
Okay.
Go Bucks. Go Bucks, guys.
Thanks, Rachel. And for lunch today, we have grilled ham sandwich or pizza, scalloped potatoes, fruit cup, and milk.
And again, we'd like to thank Whitey's for donating some of their supplies for us all week.
And make it a great day, Medina. Go Buckeyes.